Scott Peters with me now from Muncie PAs. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Good. Thanks for stopping by this evening.
Yeah, glad to be here.
Yeah, staying busy out there in the sunshine.
Yes.
And
yeah.
Good. And it's tax season.
Yes, it is. It's in full swing now.
So you're busy.
Yep. Lots of appointments being made, lots of correspondence going back and forth with clients, getting your tax data together and getting ready for the season.
Well, and a lot of questions, I imagine, this year with the new tax law.
Yeah, so obviously 2017 wasn't affected by the new law, but people are starting to think about 18 and prepare for that.
Okay. Is that personal or business?
Both.
Or, yeah, both.
It's changes to both. So one of the biggest changes on the business side is the qualified business income deduction, which can be quite complicated.
Mm-hmm.
But any pass-through entity that has qualified business income is going to get an additional deduction of 20%. That's the generalization. But it's good to get with your CPA and sort of plan for that.
Yeah. Well, I know when you and I talked last, you brought in one of those kind of pamphlets or an informational packet on some of those, that new tax law, and explaining it a little bit more simply for us people to understand. You did a really good job with that.
Yeah.
So that's awesome. When people call you, you're able to answer some of those questions in a way that people can understand, which is great.
And a lot of the laws won't affect everybody. Maybe there's one piece of it that might affect you. Everyone's tax situation is different, so it's just a matter of going through that and maybe identifying some things and asking the right questions to your CPA.
Cool. Tell me about bookkeeping.
Bookkeeping is very important to all businesses. You know, that's your foundation of your record keeping, that which is what we use to prepare the tax return. So a lot of times, if your bookkeeping's messy or it's not very put together well, or maybe you don't have anyone that's experienced doing bookkeeping, it can really affect you and it can cause you some issues down the road and additional tax if you're not doing it right.
Wow. Yeah. So that's not something you want to mess around with.
No. I always suggest get a qualified bookkeeper, even if you have somebody that's maybe entry level that's learning it. Get somebody in there that can train them properly, because it's going to save you in the end.
Yeah. I couldn't imagine being hit with something years down the road after bringing someone new on, newer person on, a little green in the field, if you will.
Right. So if you know someone's pretty green, then maybe you want to hire somebody to come in as a consulting and just say, hey, let's do a little training with your internal bookkeeper. Make sure they're doing it right from day one. Don't wait a whole year and then try to play catch up. That's where people get into issues.
Got it. R&D credits.
R&D credits, research and development, something that our firm specializes in. Anything in technology related, that's something new to your company, and you pay somebody wages or supplies, materials, can be pretty substantial especially for manufacturing companies or anybody essentially doing any sort of research and development that's new to them.
Okay.
You don't have to be a big corporation. You can be a small mom and pop shop, but if you do R&D and you're not sure about it, the best thing to do is just call your CPA and ask them about it. If they don't do it, we're always here to help.
Awesome. How long have you been doing this?
8 years.
Yeah? What got you into it?
I started off as an intern with this firm in Los Angeles, and just thought I'd get my feet wet in the professional world. Didn't really know what I wanted to do, and then after a couple of years, I decided to get licensed and then just pursued it from there.
That's fantastic. That's really cool. It is definitely a talent. You do need to know the new law and all the ins and outs of operating a business and the numbers of all that. So huge props to you. There's a lot to it.
And not every CPA is, most CPAs, are going to just get your information, your data, and prep the return and say, oh, here you go.
Yeah.
Whereas if you have a proactive CPA that's going to really work with you in terms of tax planning, getting on your case about making sure your books are updated, looking at all the tax credits and different things that might benefit
you. Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
We'll be right back.